Good morning, Facebook, YouTube, everyone out there in the virtual world. Welcome to worship. Out, and it has a whole bunch of things, but we'll just use these to
put a buck or two in, and then when the offering plate goes around, you can just put it in there, and all of those monies will go to our hunger appeal for the month of September. So there. And now Janice knows too, because she does that counting. We'll get a drop box on the front of the website too, so that people can also do it there. But I think there's an other that you could write that in too. There are thank you notes for us to put together over there for Resurrection Episcopal. We will give that to them next Sunday as we say thank you to them for our time together at our joint worship service, which will be at 10 o'clock in their sanctuary, and then fellowship as well. And we got them a little cake that says thank you on it, and I don't know what else is happening. So, but Joe knows the music, and I know what's happening, and God will send the Holy Spirit this week to pull it all together. Micah's Backpack, so some of our regular stuff. Micah's Backpacks is this Wednesday at 4:30. Thursday morning is the coffee shop Bible study. So next Sunday, 10 a.m. So really don't come any later. Just come when you usually come. And then a few other things. The Peace by Chocolate from Lutheran Social Services is September 14th, 5 p.m. It's a documentary movie about a Syrian refugee family who was relocated to Canada, and he was a master chocolatier in Syria, and this, so peace through chocolate really became their refugee or their immigrant story. God's Work Our Hands is the 15th, so 2 weeks from today. Teresa was going to like coordinate that, but now she realized that she's gonna be out of town, so I need somebody to step up and help do that. So let me know. Then on the 21st, is the 21st? I don't think it's a Saturday.
It is.
1/8/15/22. 22. Okay. 22nd is a Sunday. All right. I don't know if the LSS annual meeting is on a Saturday, but it could be. So let me check on that. But we can bring two members with me to that, and I have one person that's coming. So if there's another person that wants to come to the LSS annual meeting, I will look up details on my phone in a bit for that. It could be on a Saturday, but I don't know.
I assume Kelly looked it up.
Me too.
She
me too.
That day,
so, yeah. But then it's like, yeah. In my head, it doesn't make sense. Moving details are still up in the air. I have texted the board trustee over at Arlington United Methodist and asked about getting a few of us in early to set up Wi-Fi and all that kind of stuff. And so that will determine when and how we pack. So hold on to that. And then once we get there, y'all, hold on to your bootstraps, because on Saturday the 5th, we are hosting a tent at Pride in the River City for Jacksonville Pride Fest at Riverside Park. And then on the 6th will be our first worship service in our new location. And then on the 9th at 6 p.m. that Wednesday, we're having our first craft night. Hallie's in charge. She needs reservations though to see like what we're gonna do and how much kind of stuff and all that. And then of course, always Box Tops. Download the app and help us to help our kids. So Bible study on Thursday morning actually prompted the question for this week. So, and it goes with the readings, of course, if you hadn't gathered that by now. What have you done to take care of your heart this week? Bob?
I exercise.
You exercise, so physically taking care of your heart. Nice.
I read a newspaper article that was about a bunch of people that are apparently doing something called a life review, and there are people that pay money to have somebody else walk them. I'm like, I don't need somebody else. But I kind of started a journal, and I'm just going as far back as I can remember, and just things that I can recall, nice. Life events, yeah. You know, like when my grandmother died when I was 5, mm-hmm. and when I was 3 and fell down the steps.
Right?
I mean, you know, yeah.
That's cool.
I'm going to see how far I can keep going with that, you know, a little bit at a time.
That's awesome.
But the idea being, it's supposed to be helpful in finding the thread to what's most important to you now. You know, the things that affected you.
Yep.
I've already figured out why I'm afraid to stand at the edge of a cliff, though. Stairs.
Yeah, in the psychology world, we call those chain analysis. Look back and see where you could have stopped what is happening now. Because it's usually in a crisis. We're like, let's go back and see where you could have stopped this behavior. Yeah, but that's cool though. I like that.
But it also, you know, where did I feel a whole lot of joy, and why did that give me joy? And you know, and people I miss, and people I'm really glad were in my life, and things like that. You know,
that's
and
cool. I just thought, a life review.
A life review.
Yeah. Wow, that's a challenge. Gee.
It's fun.
That sounds fascinating.
I just started, but it's.
Yeah, I wouldn't pay anybody to do that either.
No. I don't want to tell you. I'll write it in a book.
Where else have you found joy or taken care of your heart this week? Megan?
I love fall.
This is fall?
Well, it's going to be.
When?
I love fall and I planted your
seasons. Wow. So you're taking care of your heart by planning to enjoy the season you enjoy the most. I love it. Preparing hearts. I found joy in the fact that I didn't get a bruised face when I face planted on Friday afternoon. And I think, you know, I have a little concussion going on, but I think I'm okay. So I have been concussed. So yeah. Watch out. No, they probably will see no difference in how I usually act. Good clarification. Oh my goodness. Who else has, what have you done to take care of your heart this week, or your soul, or what brought you life?
Oh, just being on the open ocean this last weekend.
Being on the open ocean.
It's a lot.
Yeah. It's ominous and powerful and gorgeous all at the same time. Yeah. Nice. Then you go to bed and you continue to rock.
Goes with
it. Yeah, it does. Yeah. Anybody else want to share? You don't have to. All right. Well, welcome to worship then. Today we are going to hear from the Gospel of Mark again. We're back in Mark. No more bread. Sorry. And then we are going to start a little bit of hearing from the book of James. And so if those things intrigue you, you may join us at 9:00 on Thursday morning and talk more fully about them at Grounds of Grace Coffee Shop. Please stand if you are able to sing our opening song.
Oh, Thank you.
are weak and wayward creatures. Protect us from all dangers that attack us from the outside, and cleanse us from all evil that arises from within ourselves, that we may preserve through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. Congregation may be seated as we hear God's word.
The psalm today is Psalm 15 and will be spoken whole verse by whole verse. Lord, who may dwell in your tabernacle? Who may abide upon your holy hill?
Those who lead a blameless life and do what is right, who speak the truth from their hearts.
They do not slander with the tongue. They do no evil to their friends. They do not cast discredit upon a neighbor.
In their sight, the wicked are rejected, but they honor those who fear the Lord. They have sworn upon their oath and do not take back their word.
They do not give their money in hope or gain, nor do they take bribes against the innocent. Those who do these things shall never be overthrown. The reading today is from James chapter 1. Every generous act of giving with every perfect gift is from above, coming down from the Father height, for the Father of lights, with whom there is no variation or shadow due to change. In fulfillment of his own purpose, he gave us birth by the word of truth, so that we would become a kind of first fruits of his creatures. You must understand this, my beloved. Let everyone be quick to listen, slow to speak, slow to anger, for your anger does not produce God's righteousness. Therefore, rid yourselves of all sordidness and rank growth of wickedness, and welcome with meekness the implanted word that has the power to save your souls. But be doers of the word, and not merely hearers who deceive themselves. For if any are hearers of the word and not doers, they are like those who look at themselves in a mirror. For they look at themselves and, going away, immediately forget what they were like. But those who look into the perfect law, the law of liberty, and persevere, being not hearers who forget, but doers who act, they are blessed in their doing. If any think they are religious and do not bridle their tongues but deceive their hearts, their religion is worthless. Religion that is pure and undefiled before God the Father is this: to care for orphans and widows in their distress, and to keep oneself unsustained by the world. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. The washing of cups, pots, and bronze kettles. So the Pharisees and the scribes asked Jesus, "Why do your disciples not live according to the tradition of the elders, but eat with defiled hands?" And he said to them, Isaiah prophesies right about you hypocrites. As it is written, this people honors me with their lips, but their hearts are far from me. In vain do they worship me, teaching human precepts as doctrine. You abandon the commandments of God and hold to human traditions. Then Jesus called the crowd again and said to them, listen to me, all of you, and understand. There is nothing outside of a person that by going in can defile, but the things that come out are what defile. For it is from within, from the human heart, all evil intentions come. Fornication, theft, murder, adultery, avarice, wickedness, deceit, licentiousness, envy, slander, pride, folly. All these evil things come from within, and they defile a person. This is the gospel of our Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ.
Ooh, welcome back to Mark. Welcome to your favorite season of the year. Oh, these are hard, right? These are amping up. Jesus' call to, we don't always have to do what we always did because we'll always get what we always got, and I am here to make a new creation. I am here to bring about a new way of love from God and from us to others. Stating that sin is really when we have rules that keep others out, as opposed to saying, welcome, be a part of us. It is behaviors and actions that defile us, not what is in this world. It is a really great time for that life review, right? Where we can look at ourselves, and you don't have to write it down. But what if we spent a little bit of time going, sometimes I talk about this, but do that. Or sometimes I understand that my behavior, my words are hurtful and harmful. And sometimes I believe that I keep others out by saying these are the rules that we have set because this is who we are. And it's not just church, it's civic organizations, you know, those Masons. You can't get in through the secret door unless you know the secret password. And so you have to belong to something. And there's nothing wrong with belonging to something. It is when we make it about keeping away others. It is about when we separate us from them. This is a common theme of Jesus' teachings, if you recall. Jesus is trying to set a new way of being in the world. Like, it's really good practice to wash your hands before you eat. In those days, and even now, I remember during COVID, some people would wash their groceries when they brought them home. And we wash our pots and pans and our bronze kettles. That's a really good practice. Especially back in Old Testament days, when, you know, there wasn't as many electronic devices to help us. And so it's not that those are bad, but there's no law about it. It's a tradition. It's a precept of what they found works. And it's really good practice. We still teach them to wash their hands before they eat, or after you use the restroom, or before you shake somebody's hand, or when you shook someone's hand, or, you know, we have things that keep us healthy, and those are good things. It's when they get in the way of loving our neighbor as God has loved us. Bam. That's what Jesus is trying to teach us. And then, James. So this is kind of, we think, it is James, brother of Jesus, that was written, and so he would have grown up with Jesus, and Mary, as the best mom in the world, taught him all of these things that your goodness in the world is what brings life, and anger, and deceit, and all of those fun liberties and laws and all that are meant to help us to live a more full life, As we say the commandments, they keep us in relationship with God and relationship with others. And so if, and you all know Martin Luther didn't like this book because of this line, but be doers of the word and not merely hearers who deceive themselves. And so as a man, we talked about this at Bible study on Thursday, as a man of his time, he was trying to get ordinary people that believed in God, who believed in Jesus Christ, who went to church, to understand who this God of Scripture is, because the leaders of the church were telling them one thing, but making the others do things, those little indulgences things, is mostly this. And so don't do stuff with your, or be, don't just talk about your faith, but do stuff. Don't just come to church and worship, but also go out and serve the world. And I do believe Martin Luther would really be happy that we are both and in that. That we come and we worship and we're fed and we're nourished and we hear the word of God interpreted for our time, and then we go out in the world and serve our neighbors as ourselves. But those who look into the perfect law, the law of liberty, and preserve, being not hearers who forget, but doers of who act. They are the blessing in their doing. And I loved the image in here of you look in a mirror and you see yourself and you walk away and you forget what you look like. And I was like, oh, yeah. Because, yeah. But then, what if every time I looked at someone's beautiful face, I saw them as a child of God and nothing more or nothing less? The mirror that God gives us is to see one another as beloved children of God and knock off all the other stuff of us versus them and keeping things out and make sure that our behaviors and our words and our actions truly live out what we proclaim here in our faith. Because we are built to serve. We are loved into service. We love our God, and we know we are called to this service, to this kindness, to this looking at others as one of us in the body of Christ. And we cannot do it alone. We need the Spirit. We need the teachings of Jesus. We need our Creator to bring us together into relationship with our God, to serve the world and one another. Amen. You may remain seated for the song.
Thank you.
words of the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty,
creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, God's only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven. He is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
Drawn together in the power of the Holy Spirit, we pray with confidence for the Church, God's good creation, and all who are in need. God of creation, you named humans as co-creators with you. Where the earth cries out in pain, bring wholeness. Guide governments and industry that environmental laws and practices seek to heal and not harm. Bring relief and justice to people and places suffering from climate catastrophes. Merciful God,
receive our prayer.
Sovereign God, we pray for local communities of every kind, rural and urban, established and new. Lead those in authority to seek the good of all through their words and actions, and to mentor others in honest and generous ways. Merciful God,
receive our prayer.
God of love and wisdom, help us to understand your will for St. Matthew's and all churches. Be with us as we experience transition, redevelopment, and in the exciting yet frightening path of newness. May your wisdom be found at every step. Merciful God,
receive our prayer.
Healing God, you draw near to all who are hurting. Be with all who desire relief from chronic and acute illness, cancer, post-traumatic stress disorder. Strengthen healthcare workers, therapists, and caregivers. Tend to those who are close in our hearts. We lift their names to you now. Merciful God,
receive our prayer.
While this Labor Day weekend, we remember and give thanks for all who have fought for workers' rights around the world, continue to improve working conditions and establish fair wages so that all people may thrive. Merciful God,
receive our prayer.
We entrust these and all our prayers to you, Holy God, in the name of your beloved child, Jesus Christ, our Savior.
Amen.
The peace of Christ be with you always.
And also with you.
Thank you. Please take a moment and share God's peace with those near or around you or in your phone. At this time that we take a pause and we give back a little bit of the abundance that God has given us as we receive our offering. pray. Blessed are you, O God, source of every gift of your creation. By these gifts, with our lives, help us to serve one another and in all we need. Through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
Give thanks to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is right to give our thanks and praise. It is indeed right, our duty and our joy, that we should at all times and in all places give thanks and praise to you, Almighty and merciful God, through our Savior Jesus Christ, who on this day overcame death and the grave, and by his glorious resurrection opened to us the way of everlasting life. And so with all the choirs of angels, with the church on earth and the hosts of heaven, we praise your name and join their unending hymn. He gave thanks and he gave it for all to drink, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sin. Do this in remembrance of me." Gathered into one by the Holy Spirit, we pray as Jesus taught us.
Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as in heaven.
Give us today our daily bread.
Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen.
This is the abundant feast that God has given us. In this is mercy, grace, and forgiveness. All are welcome at this table. Come. This is the body of Christ given for you.
This is the blood of Christ.
This is the body of Christ given for you.
This is the blood of
Christ. This is the body of Christ given for you.
This is the blood of Christ.
This is the body of Christ given for you.
This is the blood of Christ.
This is the body of Christ given for you.
This is the blood of Christ shed for you.
The body of Christ given for you.
This is the blood of Christ.
This is the body of Christ given for you.
This is the blood of Christ shed for you.
The body of Christ given for you.
This is the blood of Christ shed for you.
This is the body of Christ given for you.
This is the blood of Christ.
Thank you.
now and forever. Amen. Let us pray. Holy God, you have welcomed us to this meal and fed us with dignity at your table. Send us now to welcome others and be at peace with one another. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Receive your blessing. God Almighty, God most merciful, bless you and keep you and give you peace. Amen. We sing.